Favorite. Oh, Jim Swartingen, when is your next meet you'll be releasing for us? Band members in different locations.
Oh, well, I'm not sure. You've been looking at my Facebook page. Hello, Jim. Yes, you posted some of our rehearsals, I noticed. And thank you. You posted some of our tunes that I can't find anymore. We're just trying to work out how we can do a socially distanced live stream. So we've got a studio. We've kind of broadcast some rehearsals from there just to send out to people who like our music, because that's just us preparing for a gig. But now we're not doing the actual gigs. We'll probably have to do the gigs in there, but now we're not even allowed to have anyone in the room, I don't think. Although it is our place of work, but is it essential work? Please send
It's,
your
I think
piece of
get
paper.
visible anywhere if you want it. It's there's so many bizarre rules.
Yeah.
Can't make head nor tail of it.
I know. Well, I have had some big photographs blown up of members of the band, so we've got them in the room. Tempting fate, I think. I did this a few weeks ago. If any chance we should not be able to have the band in the room, how could we represent them? Because you can do Zoom performances and everyone's in little boxes, but after a while they tend to look the same. So I was sort of thinking ahead, thinking how could we do a few songs, get the band to perform elsewhere or send in their recordings and we'll perform along with them and then we can broadcast them. But we're still trying to work out how to do that, really. I mean, it's much more fun to be together on the stage because you feed off each other, and to be performing to a real audience because we feed off the audience. And it's great to actually, if you've written a song, recorded it, to go and release it out into the world and, and share it with people.